హాయ్ వ్యూయర్స్, వైజాగ్ విజన్ ఛానల్ ని సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేసుకోండి. మా ఛానల్ అందిస్తున్న జాతీయ అంతర్జాతీయ స్థాయి వార్తా విశేషాలు నోటిఫికేషన్స్ కోసం ఇక్కడ కనిపిస్తున్న బెల్ ఐకాన్ ని క్లిక్ చేయండి. ఎటువంటి ఆరోగ్య సమస్యలైనా ప్రముఖ వైద్యులతో చక్కటి పరిష్కార మార్గాలు మీ వైజాగ్ విజన్ హెల్త్ హబ్ లో.
Hello everyone, I am Dr. Madhavi, expert in internal Ayurvedic medicine and Panchakarma. So today's topic is migraine. As per Ayurvedic perspective, we can correlate it with Ardhavabhedaka. What is migraine? Nowadays everyone is facing hectic schedule. Because of inescapable stressful life, everyone is feeling headache. Amongst the worldwide population, 40% of population have experienced the problem of headache. Because of this headache, we are not able to do our daily routine work and daily routine activities. So because of this migraine or Ardhavabhedaka, what is the migraine? This is the persistent headache which is the highly intensity, which affects our other organs also, like brain, eye and autonomous nervous system. It is very highly prevalent headache which affects our day-to-day life. So migraine, we have to consider it is as a shirashul, as a one of the headache which we have to look after in a serious way. So what are the causative factors for the migraine or for Ardhavabhedaka? In Ayurvedic perspective, Ardhavabhedaka means Ardha and Bhedaka. So Ardha means only half side, like wherever the shirashul or the headache is present only on the half side of the head. So what, and Bhedaka means the type of the headache is the pain of the headache, means like piercing pain, pounding pain, or pain, the patient feels the pains like someone is putting hammer on her or his head. The intensity of the headache is like that only. So we have to look after the what are the causative factor for this high intensity headache. What we should do, what are the do's and don'ts, what are the advisable causative factors, and what is the triggering factors for this migraines. So as per Ayurveda, always Ayurveda recommended that good food and good lifestyle, but because of this improper diet and improper lifestyles, we are facing too much challenges, too much health issues nowadays. So what are the causative factors which affects directly impact on our health and results into migraine like headache? So the first causes that improper diet, that before intake of dry fruits, like excessive intake of vatavardhak foods. Vatavardhak means foods means dry, the food which is very dry in nature, means which causes dryness in body. So these foods is directly aggravating the vata dosha and results into headache. After that, adhyashan, which told in Ayurveda that previously consumption of food before the previous digestion of the food. So this is the direct relation that to produce toxins in our body and results into too much types of headache or too much types of diseases. So after that, more exposure to the cold and hot climate, doing strenuous exercise, taking too much excessive chilled water, frozen items, excessive exposure of breeze, excessive exposure of cold breeze, then too much inclusion in mobiles, too much inclusion in stressful life, psychological factor as well as physiological factors, both affects the cause, the pathology of migraine. Apart from this, the physiological changes which happens in the migraine, that are nowadays excessive consumption of non-veg junk foods, then excessive consumption of alcohol leads, these are also causative factors for the migraine. So what are the triggering factors for the migraine? Triggering factors may include the changes like night awakening, more inclusion in the night parties, more strainful work, more inclusions in TV, television, mobiles. We can see the fluctuations menstruation fluctuation. Then contraceptive pills can also triggers the factor like migraine. Overall, some are the foods which triggers the factor of migraine. That is the foods which contain the glutamine, and the fruits which contain monosodium glutamines. That is the food which skipping meal is also the one of the trigger factors which directly affect the hetu of the migraine. After that, some chocolates, peanut butter, aged cheese, these are nowadays we are just attracting to the market products, but these things are just have to avoid and direct trigger factor for the migraine. So now the question arising in your mind, that what are the symptoms of the migraine? Yeah, if patients are complaining that the persistent headache, like piercing headache, pounding headache, and the pulsating headache, that someone is just putting hammer on the head. So it is a very persistent headache, not able to do the daily activities, like just skipping the work, skipping the schools because of this headache. So including accompanying with this migraine headache, someone is feeling like nauseatic and omiting also there. The persistent headache till last 6 to 48 hours can be there. After that, there will be insensitive to the light, noise can be there. With the persistent headache, someone feels fatigue, loss of appetite, means no hunger is there. The headache is that much that unable to sleep. So these are the some sign is there. One can also feel the warning signs, that is in front of the eyes there will be one blind spot, there will be like stars. So these are the warning sign for the migraine. So for the avoidance of these signs and symptoms of the migraine, just avoid the causative factors or recommended Ayurvedic lifestyle. So what Ayurveda recommends and what are the measures have to take according to Ayurveda? So Ayurveda always recommends that good lifestyles, that means daily regimen and a proper food and proper lifestyle modification. So first of all, Ayurveda recommends Nidana Parivarjan. Nidana Parivarjan means whatever causative factors I have told you earlier, that is all the causative factors have to avoid it. The avoidance of the causative factors is the first preventive measures for this migraine. After that, go for changes in lifestyle. First of all, take proper food on time with like a wrong combination of the food, just avoid it. Go for the healthy food, go for nutritious food, go for fruit vegetables, avoid citrus food, avoid excessive spicy food, avoid sweet foods, and go for light food, and go for dinner with before sunset. After that, some lifestyle modification is there, that just bring all the modification according to the rhythm of the nature. That it means have to wake up early in the morning. After that, some exercises, some yoga is very beneficial for the migraine, which is the very, which is the first prevention thing, have to cure according to that. So some are the yogas which and pranayams which brings very change in the case of migraine. So pranayam is very beneficial for the migraine. After that, some yogas, omkar and all the things. After that, there are so many good herbs which keeps you just away from the migraines. There are so many Ayurvedic medicines which strengthens the nervous system, strengthens the brain nerves, and keeps the mind calm and keep away from the headache. So there are some medicines which directly act on the pathology of the migraine, which pacifies the elevated vata, pitta and rakta, which is these three things which are responsible for the pathology of the migraine as per Ayurveda. Which are the preventive measures for migraine we have discussed earlier. After that, with panchakarma we can also treat or prevent the migraine. As now abhyanga, which means the whole oil, just have to keep oil and whole oil massage, whole body massage, which plays a very beautiful role in the migraine, as it's improves the blood circulation, local blood circulations, and pacify the vata, gives nourishment, strength to the nerves, local nerves, and improves the blood circulation, so the pain will be subsided. After that, some svedan will be there. With nadi sveda, the veins which is get irritated due to the headache and due to the causative factors. So with the help of this nadi sveda, the localized vein is dilated and pain will subside. After that, nasyam is the beautiful procedure, and it is a very wonderful procedure for the sake of migraine. In this nasyam, we used to put the nasal drop of the medicated Ayurvedic oil. So it's directly acting on the pathology of the migraine. So it strengthens the CNS and give across the brain blood-brain barriers, and very important that it strengthens all the nerves tissue, which is really important for the migraine. So all these things are very important. Just first avoidance of the causative factors. After that, some preventive measures have to take. Lifestyle modification is very important. If still migraine is very chronic, then go for the internal Ayurvedic medications along with the panchakarma. And just the last thing is just avoid the self-medication with any recommendation. Just go for the authentic Ayurvedic doctor medications and just avoid the self-medication. Thank you.